It is 7 o'clock in Europe. Welcome to my live stream. My name is Mixmaster G and I'm famous for the DJ Converse utility and other tools for DJs to convert and do your collection management. This stream is all about Rekordbox. I'm going to do some stuff with Rekordbox on questions that I received. For instance, I'm going to show you why Rekordbox all of a sudden can delete tracks on a CDJ USB without you wanting it. I'm going to show you the issues some people have with Rekordbox and iTunes / the music app, because in Rekordbox the playlists are not shown, the tracks are not shown, etc. And I'm going to show you not only how you convert from Serato to a Rekordbox CDJ USB. No, I'm going to take that a step further. I'm going to show you how you can use that particular USB with Serato. So basically you have one USB and you can use it with both Serato and with CDJ USBs and with a Rekordbox collection. That is all going to be handled in this stream. First things first, today is September the 29th, which means it's almost a month before Amsterdam Dance Event starts, the biggest event in our industry. And since I'm Dutch, it's hosted in my country. And I have to warn you people who are not aware of the COVID situation in the Netherlands. The Dutch government just issued new rules and regulations regarding COVID, especially for the Amsterdam area, which comes down to hotels are not allowed to take bookings anymore. And in general, you can say Amsterdam Dance Event is off. Crowd gatherings are limited to 30 persons, 30 persons on stages. So there is no Amsterdam Dance Event as far as the festival thing is happening. There is an online event happening. The program for that still has to come out. I have not heard back what's going to happen with my workshops and my panels, so I don't know what's going to happen with that as well. But keep your eyes open for it. I hope that next year we can have the Amsterdam Dance Event, because it's always such a fun event to have. For now, back to the subject, Rekordbox, and this can get a little bit unstructured, so let's take it from the top. There are artists who use iTunes, like myself, to make their playlists and to do their basic collection management, to do the common tags and the general stuff regarding collection management. And you do it in iTunes. And then you have Rekordbox, and Rekordbox can show the iTunes playlists. And lately I see a lot of people complaining about, hey, I'm on iTunes, I'm on music, and Rekordbox is not showing me the correct playlists. This is hardly a Pioneer issue. It is more an Apple issue, and basically it requires you, the user, to know exactly how this stuff works. So I'm going to show you how this stuff works exactly. First of all, a music collection, and on this particular machine I'm using iTunes. I will log into a Catalina machine later, because I stick on my Mojave for all my operations. But Catalina is, well, the de facto standard these days. So I'm going to log in from this machine in a Catalina machine, and I'm going to show you the same thing from Catalina. Right here, we've got just some playlists, some stuff there. Nothing interesting, just your regular demo collection. And I've got Rekordbox. Let's do this first with Rekordbox 5, because there is a difference between how Rekordbox 5 works and how Rekordbox 6 works. So you need to know those differences. Here we've got the Rekordbox collection, and you need to be aware of the fact that by default, nothing can talk to iTunes. iTunes cannot do anything for us DJs, because the iTunes collection is a locked system maintained by Apple. However, Apple provided a mechanism to show the content of that iTunes collection, music collection, and that is called the iTunes XML, the dreadful iTunes XML. And in the later versions of iTunes, you have to enable it, and you do that right here under Share iTunes XML library with other applications. If you don't do that, if you don't enable it, then there is no way that Rekordbox knows about what is in your iTunes collection. It needs to know that iTunes XML file. That XML file on the old iTunes versions is automatically created. So the moment I quit my iTunes collection, my iTunes XML is updated. And let's find out where that iTunes XML exactly is. So you go to music, you go to iTunes. Let's do it on date modified. And right here, we see the iTunes library XML, which was just created. Look at the timestamp on it on the date modified. And that is the way iTunes talks to Rekordbox and tells it, hey, this stuff is in my collection. So let's go to Rekordbox, because in Rekordbox, we have to tell where that XML resides. And you do that in the preferences under advanced. And then right here, we say in the iTunes collection, let's put it on date modified. And then we need that one. And like that, at least Rekordbox knows where to look now, where to find the information from the iTunes collection. And if you open it, then you can see that there is stuff there, and there's more stuff there, and there's more stuff there, more stuff there. And indeed, everything is there. Sometimes it happens that those playlists are empty or not there at all, and you are 100% sure that the XML is fresh, has been updated, and Rekordbox is looking at the correct XML. To fix that, we go to the sync manager, and the sync manager is that thing here at the right or at the left lower hand corner. And if we click it, it brings it up. Enable all the playlists here and just set everything on. Click the big arrow, and that for sure will bring your iTunes tracks to life right here. Enabling the sync manager does something else as well. It automatically lets you analyze the tracks, let Rekordbox analyze the tracks, which can be convenient. And if you change stuff in iTunes, it automatically comes in your Rekordbox collection. So sync manager is step number 2 to do this. So far, so good. This is Rekordbox 5. As long as you are on Mojave, like I am, the things are the same in Rekordbox 6. So let's fire up Rekordbox 6 here. Let me take a nip. There we are. Again, if we go to preferences, then you see right here that we can tell the system where the iTunes library resides. There it is. And you have to make sure that it's looking at the right XML, of course. Then, just for safe measures, you see it's already enabled here. Enable everything at right and press the column. So you know that if you look in the iTunes tab, you can see that everything is there. And you see that little symbol in front of the folders. That means that they are synced. And that's exactly the way I want to have it. So far, so good. This is everything before Catalina. Now things are going to change in Catalina. And for that, I'm going to a different computer. So let's get technical here and let me fire up my TeamViewer. And hope that it doesn't fight me this time, because I had some minor troubles with it. All right, this is a Catalina machine. And I can show that to you right here. You see, Catalina machine. And we've got a music collection, because Catalina is using music and not iTunes. And if we go to the preferences, come on. We go to the preferences of music. Under advanced, no more XML export. You don't see it there. It's not there. That is because Apple wants developers to go a different route to talk to music. What Apple wants is you go through what is called an API, an application program interface. That's very technical. It's a different method to talk to music. The problem is that everything you can get from an XML is not possible to get with an API. It's fairly limited. It's controlled by Apple, something I really don't like. And an XML is readable for us humans. It's just a readable file. We can read it all. And an API is just a big black box, and you do a request and you get something out, and you must hope it is the correct thing. So APIs are not my preferred way of talking to iTunes. Lucky for us, Apple tried to take away the XML export totally, but it's still there. And it is under file library, and then export library, right there. If you do that, and we give it a name, let's name it thislib.xml. I just do this on purpose so you can see that it is a totally different XML. Right now, my collection is exported to XML. If I fire up Rekordbox, and why not? Let's go with Rekordbox 6. Or first, let me show you the Rekordbox 5 very quickly. Still the same as in Mojave. This is 5.8.5, as you can see. Under the preferences, I really hate it when TeamViewer is trying to fight me with the menus, but this is the way it is. Under the preferences, point it to the correct one, which is now the thislib.xml, which I just produced. And again, Sync Manager, enable the whole bunch, pull on the big gray pointer there, and if we then look in the iTunes tabs, you can see that everything is there and it is linked and you can go through it. So that's in Rekordbox 5. Now in Rekordbox 6. In Rekordbox 6, you have a choice. Because I just told you about the API, the application program interface, and Rekordbox 6 allows you to go through that application program interface if you want to. The benefit of going through the API is that you no longer have to manually export your XML every time you change something in music, because if you make a new playlist, if you add a new track, you have to export that library to XML again. The thing that was normally done automatically by iTunes, now you need to do it manually if you change something. The API is real-time updated. I still prefer, like I told you, the XML, because it's more controllable and we know exactly what we are doing. Here we go. And then we go to the advanced. And here you see those two different things. You see there the load method, the framework, which is the API, or the iTunes library XML. Right now it is looking at the framework, so let's see what it shows up. Maybe it is working. Like I said, it's always a bit dicey to see if that happened or what's going to happen, but let's see, maybe it works today. Seems to be pretty good. Oh, it was already synced. I just tested it, so it was already synced, so that was good. If you want to be 100% sure about getting your music stuff in iTunes, then the proper way would be, not like this, but going to music. Come on. Always a problem if you work multiple screens. Let me put it there, then things get a little bit easier. And that's not what I need. Apple spam. Come on. Let's export the library and let's call it that XML. It really doesn't matter what name you give it, because all you need to do is load the correct one. So if we now go to the preferences in Rekordbox, if it for once wouldn't find me, there we are. And we go to advanced and we say we want to use the iTunes XML. And then we say we want, of course I didn't, that XML, it's not saved as an XML because it ends with XML. Let's do that again. Now it should find it just fine. And indeed, there we are. And you always have to refresh the contents here. And then you are looking at basically the same thing. But let me show you what the problem gets if we create a new playlist here. New list, and let's put some tracks in it, like this. Quit it, and you will see nothing changes right here because it doesn't know that it has been changed. Now, I'm not sure if Rekordbox is real-time switchable, but we can give it a try. So we go to preferences. We switch to the framework because that should be updated, which isn't, so let's quit it and let's start the Rekordbox again, which takes forever to close and to open, like this. And according to this, I think it already found new playlist. No, it didn't. Oh, that's funny. All right. So you can immediately see why I don't like this method and I prefer the XML method because that will take them for sure. Let me show that to you. And this exactly, folks, is the reason why so many artists are having a hard time getting the iTunes information into Rekordbox. And again, this is not really a pioneer issue. This is a global issue. Let's call it just library XML. That all programs that want to access iTunes information have. So it just comes apparent within Rekordbox. But basically everything is having this issue through the iTunes. And then we have the library XML like there. And again, there we are, new list there. So this is, folks, why I prefer the XML method. It's a little bit more work. You have to export your library to XML. But as you can see, that works. And the framework is always a bit of a problem. So whenever the possibility is there, go to XML. It is more reliable. And let me assure you, under Big Sur, the upcoming macOS, the music app still has the library XML export, at least in the betas I'm using. So we are still good in using that. And I hope by the time that Apple takes it away, the API is reliable enough and has all the information the XML has instead of just a subset. All right, that means I can now quit this part. I can exit TeamViewer, which is always nice to do. And then we go to the next section. First, let me ask Yvette, are there questions? No questions? Good. The next part is preparing a CDJ USB from a Serato collection, which is what most of you already know. But the second part of that particular stuff is going to be new and something very exciting. So bear with me. We start out with right here. Just your basic Prutz drive. And let me connect it and let me format it ready for use on a CDJ USB. And that means we fire up the disk utility. Which can take some time. There we are. And we erase this drive. Make sure that you are exFAT. Make sure it's master boot record. And let's name it Prutz. So we know that it was just meant for a small test. Then let's go to, why not, Serato. And let's pick a track we are going to focus on because I like to use my focus tracks. Why not something out the bangers? I really don't know what I'm loading, folks, so don't blame me for it. Put a little cue there, and then let's put a cue there. Two cues, Let's name them. This and that. So you, we have the Camella Cabello mashup with two cues in it. One here and one there. Fine. I'm going to exit this and we fire up the DJ Converse utility. And what I'm going to do rather quick because I assume that you all know how this stuff works. If not, there is a shitload of tutorials in my YouTube channel about how this works. So this is the easy part, basically. But the fun part is if you do it like here, then it's all real time, so you folks can see what's happening, what's going on, and you get an indication about how the speed is of things, but also how you can do it yourself. This is fine. Let's leave everything default. And I'm just taking this bangers playlist. I'm not going to do this with a lot of playlists. Just take the bangers, which are there. And we don't need to see the log because I know this stuff is okay. Or at least I hope so. Then we take from the selected playlist. Let's take them all, why not? Import it and override whatever you want. And we go to the bangers list. And we go to the Camella Cabello track. Where am I? There am I. And we see it got indeed two cues. Exactly as we expected. So far, so good. Next up, double checking my preferences in the devices because I noticed that they were not completely set correctly. So this is basically your very quick how you can make a CDJ drive out of a Serato collection. And I want to have it sorted on command. And I want the play mode single, which is the most important one. And I want the quantize off. That's all fine. Okay. So that's all fine. That means I can go to the sync manager and I can tell it that I want to the drive is not showing and I wonder why that is. It should be there. It is there. Oh, it's an XFAT. Ah, that's my fault. Sorry, folks. You too much used in creating quick Denon drives, which are preferably XFAT, but for CDJs and within the Pioneer DJ realm, you need to have FAT drives, which we just created. And then you see it already pop up right here under devices. So that's all good to go. Again, firing up the sync manager. And then we want to have the banger list like this. And we synchronize it and you can see it running right here, but it's already true. So that was a quickie. Now there are a few things that are important if you do this. First of all, always check that your stuff is on your USB. You can do that like this. Right here we are looking at the USB. At the moment we are in this column right here on the devices. We are looking on the USB and just take your track and load it up and it will show there. So that means that is good to go. If I eject this drive, like this, and of course, let me switch cams here. Then I can just hook it up to a CDJ USB by USB, and that will be all good to go. Like this. This is a Nexus 2. Just connect the drive. Press the dial to load it up. And let's go to the Camello track, like this. And we see it has two cues, like we expected it to be. So far, so good. Now, with it this USB, we can do something else. We can take this USB. Let me go back there. Here I am. We can take this USB to another computer and then access it from a Rekordbox collection. However, and this is very, very important, folks. Quit Rekordbox here and connect the drive back. Remember, I used the sync manager to create this USB. This is my preferred way of doing this because basically I can just dump, select the playlist I want and go for it. However, if I insert this in another one's Rekordbox collection, I run the risk that that particular Rekordbox thinks, hey, this is an automatically synced drive. Those playlists on it are no longer in the main collection. Delete them all. Erasing your USB. If you want to avoid that, you go inside the Pioneer folder and then you go inside the Rekordbox folder. And inside there, there is the playlist 3 sync file. You see it right there. That is the file that tells Rekordbox to automatically sync. If I disable it, so if I, for instance, put a 1 in front of it, and I go back to my Rekordbox, my own Rekordbox, you will see it will no longer sync it, because it doesn't know what to sync. Go to the sync manager. You see the little cross right here is off. And that is because that file was renamed. Now if I rename it back, everything comes back to life and I can sync it again. Right here, you see, all of a sudden, everything is there, ready to be synced. In general, if you use the sync manager, like I do, and you have synced a USB with your collection, as I just did, disable this file. Don't throw it away. You need it to sync the device again the moment you want to change something in the Rekordbox collection and put it on that USB. But just for the time that you don't, that you are not going to update that particular USB, rename that file. That will make sure that that drive is not being updated. So if I take this drive to the other computer I just used, the Catalina computer, remember? Let me connect to it. Like this. And then I have to walk up to it. So give me a moment. Let me see if I eject the drive. Yes, I did that. Be back in a second. I hope my microphone can go that far because the studio is rather big, so we sometimes have a long walk to do, but I'm right here at the other computer and I've inserted the drive and now I'm going to show you how that part works. And there we are. You can see the Prutz drive there. There's a little bit of a problem with that particular rig showing ejectables wrong. Don't worry about it. Let's go to Rekordbox. Why not? Let's go to Rekordbox 6, folks. That's the one. And of course you get the famous, do you want to update? No, we never want to update, and do not sync with my tech, and never sync with my tech, and no to everything, and ready to go. But I still can access now this drive, and it is completely safe to do so, because I can go to the bangers, and I can find that Camilo Cabello, Cabello, Cabello track, like here. And it's still, as you can see, cut our cues, and I can use it in a set. This is the safest way to do it. Now, remember, those tracks were coming from Serato, right? And Serato has one big benefit, and this is going to be a little bit technical, but basically it comes down to the tracks that were used in Serato are the same tracks that are on my CDJ USB, and those tracks have the cues and loops inside of them, which means that you can access them if you want to. There are some things you need to see about that, so I'm going to show you that. I just ejected that and I'm walking back to get my drive because there's a little bit of preparation we need to do in order to make that work. And of course I'm going to show you what that preparation is. Here we got my drive. Everybody knows that the CDJ USBs have an awful way of making a directory on a drive. It's just a big mess if you look at it. So that's not very useful. However, you want to have the information. So what to do, what to do. Let me fire up my Serato collection. And remember that is the Serato collection that it all originated from. And let me make it a little bit smaller so you can see what I'm doing. And let's create a new crate. This is crucial, folks. Make a new crate. It's finding the stuff from the terabyte. Let's eject the terabyte because otherwise things really get complicated here. And basically, I don't know what I'm doing. Are you ejecting that thing? All right, let's call this one USB Pruts. And in this crate, we put all the tracks that we find in the content folder. That is this folder, and just drag it in Serato, like that. Everything has been loaded up, and remember that Camilo Cabello track, if you load it up, it's still got the two cues, but this time it's from the USB drive. Tracks are not analyzed. Easiest way to go about that is to I want to go back in preparation mode. How do I do that again? I'm not a very big Serato user, as you might imagine. Never mind. Oh, prepare. Why not? No, that's the prepare list. Just leave it. Tracks need to be analyzed. You can do it in preparation mode, but because CDJs are up, it finds CDJs and it goes into performance mode. And to be very honest with you guys, I don't know how to switch preparation and performance mode in Serato, so I'm not going to analyze those. But you can see the tracks are there, you can load them up. If you look from a collection point of view, you will see duplicates now. A lot of duplicates. So if you take that Camilo away, whatever the name of that nice girl is, we should have a buttload of duplicates there, basically because the tracks exist on two locations. They exist in the main collection of Serato and they exist on the USB. The moment I throw the USB out, that will be fixed if Serato will allow it to. So let's quit this and let's Serato can take forever to unload. Eject the CDJ USB. Remember, this is still the CDJ USB. I can plug it in my CDJ, it will play. It will do everything I expect. However, if I go to my friend's computer, my friend's house, and I take the CDJ USB and connect it to his computer, as I'm doing right now, and then let me log into that computer so you can see what's going on there, because this was one of the tricks I wanted to show you guys. It's always neat to do. Where did I leave my TeamViewer? There I left my TeamViewer. And let's make it a little bit bigger. And you can see the prototype there. Now let's fire up Serato on that particular computer. And now we'll be able to analyze them, because right here you have the USB pruts, which is from our USB drive. So if I just... No idea what... Ah, there it is. We can take them all and drag them on analyze, just to have them analyzed. Of course, we have that Camila Cabello track, and if we load it up, then you see that indeed the cues are still there. And mind you, folks, this is still from a CDJ USB. So basically, that CDJ USB will double as a Serato drive and as a CDJ drive, all in the same thing. And that is something that a lot of people were asking me about. How can you do that the easy way? This is the most easiest way to do it. And if you update that CDJ USB through Rekordbox, then just throw the content folder in the USB pruts crate, or whatever crate you create for that particular USB. Make sure you make a crate for it, because otherwise it will be very hard to navigate that USB on a stranger's Serato computer. So give it a name that you know that you can identify it, and then you can just navigate to it and load whatever you want from it. Those were the subjects that I had prepared for today that I wanted to talk with you about. Next week I'm going to do another stream. Yes, yay, another stream. Where I will dive into the Rekordbox sync over Dropbox, and that will be Rekordbox 6 particularly. And I will show you some really cool tricks that you can do with the Rekordbox 6 to XML tool to create an XML file out of a Rekordbox 6 collection, which I'm the only one who can do that. Yay! I'm going to ask if there are questions. Yeah, there is a question here. So let's go to that. Yeah, I noticed that conform contrast, that indeed the full screen cam has a very notable delay on it. I don't know where it's coming from. I just noticed it myself, so it's fine for me. I don't use Serato, to be honest. Conform contrast asked me, what do you use Serato for? I don't use it. I basically just do the conversions from it. Traktor is my DJ preparation software of choice. That's where I do all my work. And Serato is just, I added Serato because some very big names asked me back in the days if I could convert back and forth Serato. First they wanted to go from Serato to Rekordbox. That was the main thing they asked me about. And because I could, I just wrote it. That was one of the first things I wrote, basically because I didn't need it, but because some people with very big names asked me for it. So that's how it came in inside my tools, but I don't use it myself. But it's one of the things that is used by a lot of DJs. Same with Virtual DJ. I don't need it, but there are a lot of artists who want to go from Virtual DJ to the other platforms. So that's why I developed it. Any other questions? Feel free to ask me. And otherwise, I'm going to shut the stream for this week. Like I said, next week will be in the cloud week, if we might say so. I'm not very fond of using the cloud to store my drives, but that's what's going to happen. Yeah, conform contract. You can always ask me that, this kind of stuff. Why not? I'm always happy to share it. I'm totally open kimono. No secrets from me. It's just I was using Traktor back in the days, because that was the first time I worked with digital software, and then we are talking about 2002 or something, not even on OS X. And after that, I found out that Rekordbox, which was what everybody was using, didn't work with Traktor. Then I found out that DJ, which I wanted to use on my iOS devices, didn't work. And that's how I started with these conversion apps. There was nothing on the market that did the stuff I wanted to do. So basically, that's why I made it myself. And then, well, you know how it works. People ask for features. I think about, is that useful for others? And if I think it's useful for others, I'm happy to build it. How to clean it up and use my tools to never lose. Conform contrast is proposing a topic for a new stream, but I'm not totally sure what you mean, buddy. So your current 1000s of big of files, big is a mess. How to clean it up? How to use any of my tools to never lose anything again. Backup, backup, backup. That's all I can say. You can use the iTunes Rekordbox collection backup tool, which I created to backup your Rekordbox and your iTunes collection. And if they overlap, they will not have overlapped files. They just use the same files. And for everything else, use Carbon Copy Cloner to back it up. I'm sure, buddy, that you will ask me the question in private. So just ask me what you want to know in private or the proposed subject for next stream, and I'm very happy to look into it. Any other questions, feel free to ask now, and otherwise I'm going to say goodbye. Oh, there's another one. ACUE, could you make an iTunes replacement that can analyze tracks, key, allow, basically do everything and then convert it to everything else. ACA, I understand what you're asking for. However, that is not how I design my tools. The philosophy behind my tools is that you use iTunes / music for everything basic collection management related, making your playlist, doing your comment tags, because that is the only tool that can sync with an iOS device. So if you want to have the same playlists on your iPhone or on your iPad, that's your only way. Second thing is, it's the only place where you can Apple script whatever you want to be done. Other tools are not Apple scriptable. An Apple script can be a huge time saver for repetitive tasks, and a lot of my tools rely on Apple script. So Apple script is a very big reason why I promote iTunes and music. And finally, if you use them correctly, they are just the best there is. Don't let them manage the storage of your track. Never let them do that. Manage them yourself. Just put them in a big folder and never look back for them. But make your playlist and everything else in iTunes and music, and you'll be good to go. And then my idea was, all right, so you have this collection management in iTunes. That's fairly simple because every software works with it. And all you need is your DJ information converted. And that is why the DJ conversion utility has so many different conversions inside it and can work on selections of crates or even modification date of tracks within a DJ software collection and convert just back to it. And if you think about the DJ conversion utility, then basically the center of the DJ conversion utility is always a Rekordbox XML, which is just used as the base system to talk between different conversion steps. So everything goes from or to a Rekordbox XML, which is at the source of it. Not because Pioneer just made the most fabulous XML thing. No, it's just because you need to have a standard, and Rekordbox XML is just as good a standard as everything else. And everybody sooner or later wants to go to Rekordbox anyway. So that's why I took that and I wanted to show you that. Let me show you the DJ conversion utility. Where are we? There are we. As you can see, Traktor, Serato, and Virtual DJ all will create that Rekordbox XML. And then finally, if you have that Rekordbox XML, you can just turn everything else on at the same time, and it will be just a single pass, and you just switch on where you want to convert to. So that is basically what you're asking for. You can just set your cues and loops in one DJ software once, and you can convert it to everything else. Problem is with one big collection manager that it is very hard to find out where modifications were made, in what software modifications were made. For instance, Rekordbox XML doesn't have a public modification date timestamp, so it's impossible to know if there were modifications made. And if you want to sync that all to a central collection, you need to know what was modified at what time and at which computer. That's too much of a hassle and can become a big mess. It's much cleaner just to say all your common, playlist stuff, all your common tag stuff, iTunes or music, or your DJ tags, like keys, like cues, like analysis, like whatever you want in the DJ software of your choice. And I don't mind what you're using. If it is Virtual DJ, Serato, Traktor, it doesn't matter, as long as you just use one place, one DJ software to set those cues, and then convert it to everything else, you'll be safe. No problem. Very, very welcome, AC. Just always welcome to ask. Conform contrast. you never saw that it could convert to iTunes and music. All right. That is, again, because it's basically a little bit about what AC asks me. I can make playlists and crates and all that particular stuff, but that would be create a big mess. It's much easier to just say, all right, I just create a playlist in one central thing. I just created the bangers playlist, and let's go to my iTunes. And these days I've got iTunes, or I've got the DJ Conversion Utility protected. If you use the wrong settings, and let me buy. These are the wrong settings, folks. These settings mean that if you drop a track in iTunes, iTunes will copy the track and make an album, artist, subfolder, or you know what thing. Basically, it will mess with your file path, and you don't want to be your file path messed with. Let me delete this complete folder. So we have an empty thing, and let's just put an empty playlist there. So we have a base there. If you fire up the DJ Conversion Utility, like, where did I leave the thing? Ah, there it is. You see that it automatically finds the Rekordbox DJs UXML. That was the one I produced at the beginning of the stream from a Serato collection. And then you say, I want to go to iTunes, start conversion. And now it should tell me that it has the wrong settings. There we are. This is exactly what I want to show you. It tells me this is not correct. So you have three options. You can abort whatever you want to do, or you can continue and iTunes will copy the tracks. We don't want that. Or you can change the settings and then tell the system that you changed the settings. And let's do that. So we do that right here. And those settings are changed, which means if I go back to DJ Conversion and say I've changed the settings, it's always fun to have iTunes up for this, because then you can see what's going on. So let me show that to you. You see there's a folder DJ Conversion Utility created there, and then the subfolders and everything else is made under it. Will be very fast because this was just a very small one. Basically, it makes, like you see it right there, the structure that is on the CDJ USB this time in iTunes. And then of course you can just drag this out, or you can just take this folder out, just however you want it. But that is how you can go from, in this case, even a Serato crate to an iTunes playlist. And again, that is for AC. You see how the Rekordbox XML is the central structure to just provide it. So you never are locked out. You don't need to do anything manual. If you want to have those Serato crates in iTunes, DJ Conversion Utility can do that for you in just a few clicks. and a little bit of waiting. All right, folks. Again, thank you all for watching. Next week will be the CloudSync stream. Don't forget to like, subscribe, etc. on all my social media outlets, because I still need all your help to show the companies in the industry that this stuff is for real and that actually people are relying on it. For now, thank you all for watching. Mixmaster G signing off.